To him be the glory. Glory to Christ. What a wonderful Savior. Yes, it is glorious to be here. It's a blessing and it is a privilege, because I was deprived from the greatest privilege that men ever can have, the preaching of the gospel of Jesus Christ. I was deprived for 27 years. You can imagine how much I adore him. I worship my Savior, and I manifested his love and me to him when I have the opportunity every single day to witness for him and through his gospel. It is a privilege. You have many privileges here too. I already enjoy many of them. You got the best here. What a wonderful thing. The Lord must be rejoicing. Yes, I remember in those days that I've been in the greatest cathedral and with the greatest choirs and singing in Latin, precisely the language of the Antichrist, you can see there was no way that you can make it even the Lord smile, because I can feel it. I can feel it. I knew not then, but I can now know that I'm sure the Lord was so sad, so sad. But I can now I can feel it, that he is rejoicing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah! What a wonderful thing to be among the living. What wonderful, what a great thing to be among the living, but what a greater thing to be alive with him. Hallelujah! Yes, it's greater. This is why the women and the apostles were rebuked and called the attention when they were looking for him in the cave where he already had risen, and they told them, don't, why you look among the dead, the one that lives? I was looking among the dead. Yes, I was looking among the dead. Because every Roman Catholic parish is a cemetery. See? You are wrong when you are looking for cemeteries where there are a lot of crosses and a lot of people physically dead. But there are living people, there are dead. More than what the ones that have been buried. A living people. I was one of them. Until I was risen with Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. See, I was always waiting for 27 years, even as a Jesuit priest, in the resurrection to come. I never knew that you can be risen with him now. Yes. I'm going to share with you many of these things that have to do with the power of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And I would like to call your attention to the Gospel of Matthew. Nevertheless, before we start this prophetical seminar, I would like to mention from the beginning that we will be talking about, during the first 3 days, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, in chapter 24 of the Gospel of Matthew, the prophetical sermon of our Lord Jesus Christ. And then before, I'm going to brief you and the many things that has happened since my testimony was revealed, as the Lord has commanded me to do, and bringing about these things that were hidden from the Church of Christ, from the Christian people, and from the Roman Catholic people too. Now, let me call your attention to chapter 24 of the Gospel of Matthew and read for you three verses. Chapter 24, I'll read to you from verse 4. Actually, let me read you verse 5, and then in order to use and redeem the time well enough, as much as we can, we would like to read certain verses instead of reading all the context, and then you have some work at home to do reading the context that you can understand better what I brought to you this evening and the following evenings. Chapter 24, verse 5, and there we read the Word of God. For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. And then verse 23. Then, if any man shall say unto you, Lo, here is Christ, or there, believe it not. And 24. For there shall arise false Christs, in plural, and false prophets, and shall shew great signs and wonders, insomuch that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. I knew both ways around these prophecies. I was deceived, and I did try for 27 years of Jesuit Roman Catholic priesthood. I have tried to deceive the very elect. As a matter of fact, that is why I was taken oath as a Jesuit under oath and induction. Only with the purpose to deceive, if it were possible, the very elect. Our Lord Jesus prophesied here, and if it were not because these prophetical signs that I have read from to you this evening, three main prophetical signs, this one in verse 5, the second in verse 23, and the third in verse 24. We will be speaking about these three prophetical signs of the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. How I knew about this is almost impossible to even go and be very specific about. There is so much about. Nevertheless, in these publications you have read some of the things that were so much a part of my conversion and then of my salvation in Christ. But I would like to brief you about several things. In this introduction of this prophetical seminar, I want for you to explain something about these publications that you are not aware of. First, these publications are not all what will be coming. This is only just a brief part of what will be coming. For those who already thought that in 1979, when Alberto came out, that was all, they receive a big surprise when they saw Double Cross coming behind. And then for those who already tried so hard, in so many ways, and so many, using so many methods and peoples and organizations and governments to stop even for any more from coming out, they were shocked when they came out and saw the Godfather. And they are still very nervous, using of all the aspirins and the pharmacies and drugstores and all kind of calmants or you call whatever drugs they can use in order to calm their nerves down, when they knew there was another coming, the force. And they keep trying until now, until this evening, they keep trying. But they have another surprise. The fifth number is coming next month, called the prophet. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! Certainly, we live in the most privileged time in history. Certainly, the most horrifying times too. But you Christian people, and those who are not Christian this evening, please close attention. You Christian people are the most privileged people in the entire world. Certainly the most suffering, certainly the more persecuted, the most rejected ones, but the most privileged one. You are being witnessed and being instruments of the greater things that not even the prophets were able to be recipient of. You are witnessing now the things that the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ and Christ our Lord himself was not even witness in their very times, and we do witness now in our partakings of the fulfillments of his prophecies. Certainly, you are privileged people. There is a lot, and this is my trust and confidence and my joy in Christ, is the joy of my salvation. And that joy increases as the days go by. And that joy gives me more strength as the times go by and the opposition increases. Then I become stronger. Yes. They can burn me alive, and I'm sure that I have the strength of the Lord himself that I'll be able to speak while I'm being burned. And the ashes will speak. And the ashes will witness of what Jesus Christ has done in my life. Oh yes, they will. I have that confidence so secure. Because I know where he brought me from. Some people see me and they said they were expecting to see a big, tall man, even a fat one, maybe big, heavy. And maybe a machine gun with me. Very ugly, awful, terrible, a criminal. Said, you see how evil this man is? He's a liar. He's a deceiver. You can see the face of the liar and deceiver. All the deceits and the lies are there. You can see how ugly he is. All the evil things that he has done against so many good Catholic people is there. He hates them all. He hates all the Catholics. He hates all the Protestants, all the Pentecostals. He hates everybody. He is against everything. And to everything he said that the Holy Mother Catholic, Roman Catholic Church is the cause of all our evils. How evil he can be. Well, all this come to this. You see, I am 5.5 and I weigh 115 pounds. I many times have a hard time trying to kill a fly. But I don't understand what is all the worry about. What is all the fear? What is all the commotion? Before even the Lord has set me free, he has set free millions and millions and billions of people around the world throughout the centuries. And many priests to place myself in their place. Many, thousands upon thousands of priests, even Jesuits, they were brought by the power of Jesus Christ out to light from darkness.